spiritual. But you know Jesus, he can clean you up, and he can make you, not only since you look bad because you're dirty, he can also make you look good, can you?
Amen.
If you'll just come to Jesus, he'll change your very countenance. Whenever the Spirit of God comes on the inside of you, he'll clean up the house, won't he? He's in the house cleaning business. Jesus can cleanse up the house. Amen. He can take that. He'll take all your old filth and dirt, all those things, won't he? And the precious blood of Jesus will do exactly what Isaiah said here. He'll make you, it said, make them white as snow. Come now, let us reason together, saith the Lord. He'll not only make you look better, he can also make you feel better. I say, oh happy days, since Jesus washed my sins away. Jesus will do that, won't he? He'll make you feel better. He'll make you look better, make you feel better, and in the sight of God, he'll make you smell better. You'll be a sweet-smelling savior when you walk in obedience under the Lord. Amen? And sometimes people won't repel from you, but they'll be actually drawn to you. Amen? When we walk in the Spirit of God, the Lord at times himself, but he says to come now. He's talking with urgency. It's a call. He wants you to come now. Come now. That's the only, right now, it's the only time we can only live in the present.
Amen.
This meeting here was designed especially for you tonight. These singers who came, be with the word tonight of the Lord, like we minded the Lord tonight, he wants you to come. And come right now. Very quickly, you know why some people don't like somebody else? And I see sometimes we may be even get a little older in life. We have to depend on someone else to help us to bathe and so forth. Some people don't like it. They don't like charity. You know why? Sometimes because of their pride and so forth. They don't like someone to help. I'm sure if you live long enough, we live long enough, you know somebody will have to help you. And here's it, John 13. Remember Peter himself? Jesus here after supper being at times, now supper being ended just before the Passover, Jesus rises up, he gets up from the table, he rises, gets up from the table, lays aside his robe. I haven't got time for that, but I can assure you there's something right there about a leader. Jesus is the same behind the scenes. What you see of Jesus is what you get.
Amen.
Jesus don't have to put on any covering, any front. What you see is what you get.
Amen.
Jesus lays aside that. He takes up a towel and he girds himself and wraps it around him. And he would appear to be look like a butler. And this is why he came. He did not come to be ministered unto, but to minister. Then he takes the form of a servant, doesn't he? Humbles himself down. The one who used to give the commands has all the time. He laid aside that robe representing. He laid aside his divinity himself and laid upon him humanity, and he humbled himself down. The one who used to give command is now taking commands. Amen. Humbles himself down to serve man. Takes that pitcher there and pours it in that basin of water and begins to stoop down and wash his disciples' feet. If you only look at foot washing, you'll miss the spiritual meaning, what the Lord's trying to say. If you only observe that as trying to clean your feet, you'll miss what he's trying to say. Because Peter himself, Peter said, Lord, thou, he said, I don't want you to wash my feet. But he said, Peter, lest I wash your feet, you'll have no part with me. And remember, the other night I said the strong point about Peter was he always wanted to be near Jesus. Amen. I want to be near Jesus myself, don't you? I want to be where Jesus is. Amen. He said, Lord, wash me. Wash me real good then, didn't he? But he took his feet. You know what the bottom of your foot's called? Your soul. Only Jesus can cleanse your soul.
Amen.
You see, there's no one else in that room could have done what Jesus did. Everyone said, well, maybe someone else could have jumped up and humbled them. And it's humility. It is a lesson in humility. It is also, though, only the Lord can cleanse your soul.
Amen.
Only Jesus can cleanse your soul. He gets rid of all the filth, doesn't he? Behold, the Bible says, behold the Lamb of God that taketh away the sins of the world. Amen. Jesus wants to wash you tonight. Jesus wants to take your old sins tonight and make you clean in the sight of God, just as pure as the driven snow. Jesus, by His precious blood, He shed on Calvary's cross and through His death, burial, and resurrection. If you come to Him tonight, believe in Him with all your heart, He'll save your very soul tonight. Ask Him to forgive you of your sins. And the Bible said in 1 John 1:9 that if we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us and to cleanse us. To cleanse us from some? No, to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Amen? I believe it's wash day, ain't it?
Amen.
Now, scarlet, in this sense here in the Bible, in this text, He said, come now, let us reason together. Please stand. As the singers come, whoever's got a song tonight, invitation time, this is a time of reverence. But here in this particular text, He says, come now, let us reason together, saith the Lord, though your sins be as scarlet. You know what scarlet? There's a scarlet, is a small, like shrub tree. And it's used to make black dye. They take the bark up off that tree and they make a black dye. Though your sins be as scarlet. You see, your sins in the sight of God, it's darkness. It represents darkness. It represents black. But then, and some of you probably remember as well, have, that Calvin Ray Evans preached on the crimson worm. And Jesus also identified Himself, and He related that because Jesus said, I am a worm. And He related that the crimson worm. The crimson, He goes up with that worm, goes up that shrub. And when it goes up, it lays its eggs, it fastens itself to the tree. It lays its eggs, then it secretes a red gel up over that, up over its young. And it represents, just like Jesus, that tree. He went up on that old dark tree, Calvary's tree. Black represents the judgment. And Christ went upon that tree. Like that worm, He shed His precious blood so He could cover all of His young. And you need to be covered by the blood.
Amen.
Be covered by the blood of Jesus. But here's what the blood will do. He'll take an old black heart like that tree. When they scrape that worm, they'll scrape that worm off and make that dye, red dye. But when they scrape it off, it's just as white as can be. Isn't it amazing how God can take a black heart, dip it with red blood, and make it as white as snow?
Mom!
That's good. That's the truth. Jesus will do that. You step out of faith tonight. Only He can cleanse you. Only He, only holiness. Real holiness and makes you a fit subject for the kingdom of heaven is through the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen? That's the only way. It's through the Lord tonight. Why don't you come? You want to be pure tonight, clean? The only way is get your sins underneath the blood of the Lamb and let Him cloak you with His righteousness. He'll impute righteousness unto you. Where you before you never had it before, you come just as you are. Down this altar tonight, come just as you are. Without one plea, you call out upon Jesus and let Him save you. It'll still take purity. Who shall ascend into heaven? He that has a pure heart, clean hands. The only way you can ever be clean is through the Lord Jesus Christ. As they say, come. You need to come pray. Come on down.